Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be showing you guys how to use aloe vera two different ways. So the first way is as a pre-poo, and then of course I'm going to be using it to make a detangler. So to make the pre-poo and a detangler, all you need is the aloe vera plant. That's it. You can get it from your local grocery store, Walmart, etc. Maybe even your backyard. I don't know. Maybe you have that. So of course, you're also going to need a few tools like a knife, a spoon, and a mixing bowl. And that's it. If you want to take the extra step and strain your aloe vera, you definitely can, but you're going to need a strainer. And just know that it may take a lot longer to do it that way. My hair is about 2 weeks old, as you guys can probably tell. It still looks pretty good. It's not too bad, but honestly, it's kind of dry. My scalp is flaky a little bit, so I definitely want to go ahead and do a pre-poo and detangle, deep condition, and all of that. I want to tell you guys a little bit about aloe vera. So aloe vera is known for soothing the scalp, especially if you have a dry and itchy scalp. It's also great for anyone who's experiencing alopecia, those who have dandruff. One of the reasons why I'm personally using it is that it helps with hair growth. If you guys have been following me, you guys know last year I did cut off about, I don't know, maybe 3-4 inches, and I was waist length and now I'm not. So I want to get back there. So that is why I'm doing whatever I can the healthy way, you know, to get my hair to grow back to waist length. So not only does it have all those great benefits, it also has vitamin B2, B6, B12. Those B vitamins are perfect for reducing hair loss. So now it's time to make the aloe pre-poo. So first you want to go ahead and rinse your plant with warm water so that way there's no dirt when you're cutting the plant. Next, you're taking a knife and cutting off all the sharp edges. After that, you're gonna go ahead and cut the aloe plant into small pieces. After that's done, you wanna cut each piece in half. And then finally, you want to take a knife or a spoon and scoop out the aloe vera. And then finally, you want to take the aloe vera and squeeze it in your hands and squeeze out all the juice that you can. You can definitely go ahead and put this in a blender or use a strainer. The choice is really up to you. For me, I decided to just use my hands and squeeze the juice out. Alright guys, so the next step is to, you want to section your hair, but you also kind of want to dampen it so that way it makes it a little bit easier to move your hair around and apply the aloe vera. I'm just going to go ahead and use my mist spray bottle to dampen this section. So I'm just going to be taking the aloe vera and applying it directly to my hair. And of course, I'm going to be applying it to my scalp because I want to make sure that every strand is covered. There you go. Ooh, it's very, very slimy, just so you know. Oh my gosh, it's extremely, extremely slimy. So as I'm applying this, detangling with my fingers a little bit, and I'm going to go ahead and split that section and add some aloe vera in between. So once that section is covered, I'm going to put that section away. Now working on the front section, I'm gonna do the same thing, adding the aloe vera to my hair, smoothing it in, taking that section and getting the aloe vera up to the scalp and smoothing it in. So now that the aloe vera is in my hair, it's time for me to detangle. I'm just gonna take my wide tooth comb and I'm going to begin detangling my hair. And remember, this was a wash and go. So my hair had lots of knots, lots of curls, and my hair is actually detangling really, really well. So this is actually, I'm actually kind of surprised. Wow. Okay, so this is me detangling my hair. So you can use it as a pre-poo, a detangler, you can use it as a hair mask, so many different things. So this is pretty good that my brush is just sliding through my hair. Wow. So the aloe vera is all over my hair. As you guys can probably see, there's little pieces, which I probably will remove before I actually hop in the shower. So
Right now, I'm gonna go ahead and put on a plastic bag, pretending that it is a shower cap. And I'm gonna keep it on for about 30 minutes, and then I'm gonna hop in the shower.
So after pre-pooing for about 30 minutes, I'm now in the shower, and I'm just rinsing out the aloe vera out of my hair with warm water. And it's rinsing out really, really well. I was expecting it to be a lot harder just because it's so sticky and so gooey, but it honestly rinsed out really, really well. It left my hair feeling very soft, and also my curls were really defined, which you guys will see later on in the video. So after pre-pooing, you definitely want to follow up with shampooing your hair and conditioning and doing your normal wash day routine. So this is what my hair looks like after rinsing out the aloe vera. My hair looks really, really defined. I was quite impressed with how it worked on a wash and go. I've never done a wash and go, and I was expecting it to be a little bit tricky to work with, but it honestly did a really good job. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please share it with your friends and family. Leave me a like, a comment, and subscribe if you haven't.